Without a power supply running properly, our PCs would just sit there. But how do we know if we're having power supply issues? Let's take it to the bench, ask Wes, and find out. Hey, Wes, I want you to know I put my detective hat on because there's something going on with someone's PC who shall remain nameless.
Okay.
And it might be related to the power supply. So,
okay.
Symptoms of power supply issues. How do we find those symptoms? How do we know it might be the power supply?
I'll tell you, one of the telltale signs is the fact that when you press power on your computer, nothing happens.
I figured that was that.
Yeah, it's not always as easy. And fair, you know, in being fair, no, it's not always that easy. Sometimes you might have a power supply that's failing, and when that happens, it fails to deliver the proper power outputs to different devices, and you might see like intermittent symptoms where maybe you get a crash if you have, like, for instance, you're launching up a very intensive graphical type application where maybe your graphics card isn't being powered to its fullest. You might get a random reboot. You might get a system lockup. For the most part, a lot of times what you're going to see is just a failure to boot in general.
Spinning beach ball of death might happen to
you? No. In fact, when we talk about that, it might just be the fact that you hit the power button.
Yeah.
And absolutely nothing happens.
Okay.
Doesn't turn on, no hard drive LED light indicator like the drive, none of the fans are spinning. Or you might actually see where the fans spin, but it still doesn't come on. So those are usually kind of the telltale signs. You might get some kind of, you know, we say spinning beach ball, that's typically a Mac thing.
Right.
If you're talking about where we've been more in the PC world, if it's a Linux system, it might be a kernel panic, which they're pretty much all kernel panics. They're just proprietary crash screens. In the Windows world, it would be the legendary BSOD, or blue screen of death.
Right. Spinning Cheerios is what I was referring to.
Yes, there we go. Absolutely. It certainly could happen.
Yeah, okay. Well, all right, so some symptoms. What's the causes? What's happening? What's going on?
Okay, well, there could be a few things that are causing, potentially causing the problem. If you are looking at power issues, it could be the fact that maybe your power cable isn't plugged in.
Mm-hmm.
It could be just as simple as that. Have you moved your desk lately? I know that when I have a PC like this, in fact, I had a PC next to my desk for a very long time, didn't move it at all, but went to move the desk one day, and after plugging different things in, and you just kind of, it gets to become a big rat's nest back there, or unplugging a device. I had a top mount power supply. Like, for instance, we'll see in this one. This one's a bottom mount power supply. And unplugging one of the USB devices, pulled the power cord out of the back, moving the desk that it was at, kind of shimmied the power cable so it wasn't properly seated. So those are very basic things, and they're really not power supply issues as more as they are more of like an operator error. And again, I don't mean that facetiously. I just mean that, you know, it's not really the internal component that's failing.
Could it be the power strip you're using, or surge protector or something?
That is a great thing, you know, and I'm glad you mentioned that, because that is, especially, you know, here in Florida, you know, we get two seasons. We get hot and rain, and that rain usually comes with lightning.
And if you don't like the weather, just wait a minute.
That's right. Wait 5 minutes, it'll change. So if a power surge does happen and it trips the power surge or the surge suppressor, it could trip the fuse that's in it, and that could be a problem. Or it could be just the fact that maybe it's turned off. You know, maybe that you've kicked the power adapter. If it's not a surge protector, or even if it is, if it's just a normal you know, power strip, which is really just a way to add more devices to a single AC outlet, that could be the problem. Really, it could be the AC outlet. One of the things that I do when I'm testing that out, if I want to figure out if the power supply issue is, I take a lamp, you know, turn it on, and then unplug it from its power source and bring it over to the same AC outlet that your computer's plugged into, and plug it in. If the light comes on, then you know the AC outlet's, you know, is working. It's a real easy way if you don't have, you know, a voltage detector or something, you know, because a lot of people don't have these things just laying around. It's a real easy way to test an AC outlet. Other things that it could be, too, it could be, we've talked about the loose main power connector. I've talked about the external power connector. If you're working inside of the PC, it could be something like the internal main power connector. If you're putting everything back together and it's not fully seated, in the Into that 24-pin connector, mm-hmm. provided you're, which most people are running the ATX standard today, that could cause problems as well. Other minor things that can happen, some of the older power supplies, they have voltage selector switches, and that's called input power selectors. And these are little red like dials that you can, a selector switch that you can usually take a screwdriver and you can move it to one of two positions. 115 or 225, which mm-hmm. is really just 110 and 220 right. In the European nations here, or the European states and stuff that use 220. And if that selector switch isn't on the right appropriate voltage selection, then it could underpower the machine. It could cause issues. The reverse of that is if it's expecting to be to have an input power of 115 and you put it on a 220 circuit, you could just fry the power supply. Mm-hmm. I didn't mention this one symptom, and mm-hmm. it is a symptom of a failing power supply. All if right. you smell burning plastic or a burnt smell, yeah. That could be a good a symptom of a power supply issue. Mm-hmm. And I say that from kind of personal experience. Again, living here in Florida, mm-hmm. Lightning strikes happen, mm-hmm. and one of my friends had a workstation, and she went out for a little bit, and it was raining and everything. Come back, said her computer wasn't working. Just asked if I would take a look at it, and when we, you know, when we opened up the computer, you really didn't even need to open the computer up. You could just kind of smell.
You could smell it.
You could smell like burnt electrical, and that was just because lightning had struck her house, and unfortunately, electricity, kind of like water, follows the path of least resistance. Mm-hmm. It followed down her electrical current, down her lines, and it actually ruined a couple of things. One of the things being her PC. So, the input power supply switch. Now, there's other switches too that you can have on power supplies as well, and it could be just an on-off switch. Mm. I've done that too, where I push the power, I push the workstation back, and again, cables on the back of the of the PC turns that power switch off, and unfortunately, it's not going to cause. It's going to, you're going to think that your power supply is bad, but really, it's just an on-off switch.
Goodness gracious me. Well, okay, now all that being said, and there was quite a bit of it there, and I thank you very much.
Yeah.
How do we fix this? What are the solutions? Okay. Some of the solutions we can look at.
Sure. Let's start with visual inspections first. That's okay. One of the easiest things to do. And then it's not really, it's a smell. the sniff test, scratch and sniff. If you could smell burnt, something burnt in your computer, that's a pretty telltale sign that, especially if it comes to the power supply. Now, I will tell you, sometimes that's hard to isolate because mm-hmm. it could be a capacitor on the motherboard. You've got VRM or voltage regulator mm-hmm. modules on your motherboard too that ensure that the power is stepped down to the appropriate voltages. So one of the things to determine whether it's a power supply or something in the motherboard, you might actually have to disconnect all the connections, pull the power supply out, and kind of smell that by itself. You will,
yeah.
Because sometimes it might be hard to tell. Again, one of the easiest visual inspections, if we take a look here on the back of this computer, you can actually mm-hmm. see that this has got one of those on-off selectors that I was telling you about
yep.
As well. And if it's turned off, it's like a light switch. It's not going to bring power into the system. So again, just pay attention to that. That might be one thing. Some of the other power supplies, you'll see that little red notch here that I've told you about where it's a selector switch. And it's usually got 110 or 115 on one side and then 225 on the other side, and then you just flip it. Those are fixed input power supplies, and they don't do the auto ranging like this one does, and a lot of the newer ones do. So you may have to worry about that on some older ones. More modern models, they can pretty much, what they can do is they can detect the voltage that's coming in, and they can work with whatever the voltage is. So that's really one of the easiest things that we can do, just kind of before we even get into the computer, right? Mm-hmm. Let's see the easy, simple solutions first.
Mm-hmm.
Check your power, your AC outlet. I've already kind of told you how you can do that without having any voltage detector.
Mm-hmm.
Check the surge protector. Make sure that a fuse isn't blown in the surge protector.
Yes.
If you've just got a regular power strip, just make sure that the on-off switch hasn't mm-hmm. been kicked off. Again, I probably shouldn't admit to this. I've done that more often than I really should admit to. Now, when it comes to getting into the computer,
mm-hmm.
that's going to be a little bit different.
Oh, okay. Well, I noticed one more thing, too, here, is we've got this just kind of dangling here, I'm guessing that might be an issue.
Yeah, that might be an issue. The reason I've got this out, and I'm glad that you made note of that, is because we are dealing with power here.
Yeah.
And you want to utilize proper electrical safety here.
Right.
So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be disconnecting some connectors in here. So okay. I've disconnected the power from the power supply. And also up here on the top of the box here, in this one, check your vendor here, is the power switch. Mm-hmm. And I'm actually, I don't know if you can hear that.
I hear it.
I'm holding that in, and I'm going to try to dissipate any excess power that's in the power supply, because mm-hmm. you don't want to shock yourself.
No.
We want to make sure that we're, again, exercising proper
safety.
Exactly. So we've done that. And if we kind of take an overhead view here, we'll see there's two connectors that I really want to disconnect. And then what we're going to do is we're going to pull these through the back of the computer, and we're going to put them on a power supply tester. These mm-hmm. are the CPU connector here.
Right.
And then the other one that I'm going to do, if I kind of move this, you'll see this is the main power connector. That's the 24-pin connector. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to take these two connectors, and I'll take my light here, and we'll kind of put that to the side here.
All righty.
And go ahead and turn that off, get that out of our way. And then what I'll do is I'm going to just unplug these, and when I unplug them, mm-hmm. I'm going to feed the main power supply connector through the back.
Right.
And what we're going to do is we're going to put these on a power supply tester. Now, you could do this with a multimeter. I actually have a different, let me move this a little bit to where I can see it. I have a thermal take. It is a universal ATX power supply tester,
uh-huh.
and that's what we're going to use to actually test this these components out.
And that's not relatively expensive, is it?
Well, this one is about $40.
Well, it's
not really bad. If
no,
you do
that,
if you work as a tech, mm-hmm. I would definitely suggest having
investment.
One of these.
Yeah.
Now, what we're going to do here too, and you know what, Zach, I'm going to pull that camera out of the
sure.
way, because we're pretty much done with this.
Okay.
I'm going to pull this, what I call spaghetti, out of the back of this.
It's a very colorful spaghetti.
Yeah, it is. So we've got, and let me just undo some of the cable routing, because remember, this episode is more about testing the power supply than it is the cable routing.
That is right.
And what we end up having here, Zach, is all of our different connectors. Now, I'm going to take my power connector here, and I'm actually going to plug this back in, and we're going to turn on the power supply.
Okay.
Now, at this point, ATX standard says if this it's got a certain pin in here. If it's not connected to the motherboard, mm-hmm. the ATX power supply will not turn on.
Okay.
All right. That's just a safety mechanism. Now, if you can hand me that thermal take.
There
this
it is.
This is a multimeter. This is a multimeter, or not a multimeter, excuse me. This is a universal ATX power supply tester.
Okay.
And if we kind of take a look at this from the top here, you're going to see that it's got a few things that we can do. Mm-hmm. All right. We can plug in from the top all of our different connections. Mm-hmm. We've got a PCIe connection. We've got the old 4-pin Molex connector.
Yeah.
And then we also have our PCIe connector. So CPU connector, we've got our Molex connector on the top, this small little plastic blade, not really much to see there. That's our serial ATA connector.
Right.
And then finally we got PCIe. And then if I turn this around, you'll see there's that 24-pin connector.
Now, yes.
Now what we want to do is we're just going to take this, we're going to take the 24-pin connector, and let me see if I plug this in the right way here. The good thing is it's keyed, it's notched. You don't have to worry about it. No, notice it comes on right away.
It did.
That's what we want to see. I'm not gonna do the diagnostics yet, because what I want to do is I want to take the CPU connectors, all right, and you can just pay attention. There are marks on these right at the top, so you know exactly how they go in. And what I'll do is I'll just kind of plug these in here. That's all I'm doing. You can hear it.
The
beep is a good thing.
Beep's a good thing.
I'll come back to what that beep actually means in a second, as soon as I get these plugged in.
Yeah.
So now we've got our PCIe, our CPU, our 24-pin connector, but we got a couple other connectors that we want to test, and these are going to go through and test every single one of them. Mm-hmm. I'm going to put on our blade connector for serial ATA.
Right.
And then finally, you can see it's almost like Twister here.
Right, it was spaghetti.
It really is. Yeah. So then the next thing I'm going to do is I'll plug in the last, our Molex connector up here towards the top,
right.
Provided I can get one that's not going to give me a hard time. And the good thing is they are arranged to where you can't put these in backwards, even though there's a notch on the blade connector for serial ATA. It's pretty straightforward on how to get these in here. Now, I say that, and the Molex connector is kind of giving me a hard time. Now, if I can move these out of the way, what we want to end up seeing here, let me go ahead and kind of cycle through these.
Okay.
And there, you'd be able to see it like that. Now,
right.
Now, what we have here is, if we click this the first time, what you're going to see is that it is telling us, this is our 24-pin connector here, mm-hmm. and what we can see is the 5-volt rail, the 12-volt rail, and the 3.3-volt rail. These are important, all right, because these are the three rails, or the voltages that are,
right.
are in this computer. And if you look, they're within their tolerance ranges. Now, these voltages, if you get a power supply that's failing, they're going to be considerably lower.
Oh.
Now, considerably lower. Pay attention to your vendor, and the reason I say that is because, notice this says 12.1.
Mm-hmm.
It's supposed to be 12. Is that bad? Well, no, it's not bad. It's not bad at all. It's within its range. There you go. It times out. So it's within its range. This is a power good signal, and according to the specification, anything between 100 and 500 is good. Mm-hmm. This just says, hey, you got good power, and this is how many milliseconds. And then the next thing that we'll do is we'll click, and what it'll do is it'll go to the next rail, and this is telling me right here that this is PCI, or PCIe, excuse me. I know it says PCI on there, but technically it is PCIe.
Mm-hmm.
And notice it says 12.1 volts, and again, so it's supposed to be 12 volts. It's within its range. It's giving good power. And then the next thing we do is we'll just click through the next one here, and notice that tells me the CPU. The CPU voltage up here, that's also 12 volts. That's what we want to see. And then we've got, if we go through this, the next one here, you're going to see this is the 4-pin Molex connector. This was used on older parallel ATA drives, not really used too much as far as the parallel ATA drives go today, but you still use them for things like system fans. And notice that it's got a 5-volt and a 12-volt rail. Well, we're seeing it's within its ranges. Even if it was a little bit less, that would be perfectly fine. But I'm actually surprised and very happy with this power supply that not only is it hitting the range, it's not deviating at all. A little bit more. And then the last one here, we do this one more time. This is our serial ATA, and that's got all three rails in it. You can see we have the 5 volts. We've got the 12 volt, which, again, it's run. The 12 volt rail seems to be running just a little bit more, which is not bad. And then 3.3. So that's essentially how you can test your power supply,
fantastic.
Right? And I really like this device. Now, you can see me struggle with it for a little bit.
There's a lot to struggle with.
There is, but we also want to make sure that you can see it real well, too. And one of the reasons I like this type of device is, yes, you can use the multimeters, but you're going to have to, and certainly there's nothing wrong with multimeter, but a multimeter, you're going to have to go in and you're going to have to figure out which wire does what,
mm-hmm.
and what voltage it should be, and what the tolerance ranges are. With this, you can take one of these power supply testers, you plug them in, and then you look at the manual, you find out what the Intel specification is, and you can tell what those tolerance ranges are, and you can find it out very fast. You don't have to worry about which wire does what, because you can only plug it in one way, mm-hmm. and then you click through the interface, very easy to do, and it's very quick that you can find out whether your power supply is performing the way you want it.
Well, Wes, I and my power supply, thank you very much.